Joining me in the studio is Professor Dietmar Otte, who heads the Department of Accident Research at Hanover Medical School. Now, the German Transport Minister actually wants to reduce the traffic-related casualties by 40% by the year 2020. Can you really order by law to have less injuries and casualties on the road?
No, I think it is not a law which would like to decide here. It is more a recommendation. Mm-hmm. And the German minister is not the only one, because it is a demand, I think, from all of the countries in Europe mm-hmm. to reduce the number of fatalities within a special period. We see there is safety inside the vehicles. There is safety inside the traffic following in a reduction of the fatalities, and that can be continued for the further years. And that was decided only at this moment for the German situation.
Uh-huh. And are you actually optimistic that this number can be reached?
I'm optimistic because we can analyze the statistics, and we are seeing that we have every year a reduction. Mm-hmm. If we are implementing safety measures mm-hmm. in the vehicle, and one safety measure is the safety belt, the airbag in for frontal collisions. But on the other side, we have to see that the situation of injury changed with this. We have now injuries which are coming from very rare situations, side impacts. We have truck to car accidents, so we have to handle this problem. And if we do so, I think we are optimistic.
That means the situation in the traffic has become, so to say, a lot more complicated. But is there a single measurement you could actually take to reduce injuries and casualties?
No, there is no single one. So that is a multi-complex situation mm-hmm. between many disciplines of technique, the vehicle, mm-hmm. The medicine, the therapy of the patients in emergency handling. And we have the psychologists also in traffic situation. And one very important thing is we can reduce also the number of accidents by better information of the driver, driver assistance systems.
Electronics in the
cars. Electronics in the cars. And knowing all these kinds, we are optimistic to reduce in the future also the existing number of fatalities.
Uh-huh. But that means if we equip cars with more electronics, like we have, for example, radar distance measurements in the cars, so to say, can that really reduce the risk of going in an accident, or will people tend to drive more risky?
There are a very special number of people who are driving risky, but in the whole, we are knowing that this can follow in a reduction. And we are seeing that there will be also a good information system. So at the moment, we are seeing many accidents are happened because the driver gets these informations too late. Mm-hmm. There is if you get it 1 second earlier, then you have space for reduction of your impact speed.
That means electronics has to improve a bit. Thanks
That's
a lot
right.
for
Thank
the talk,
you.
Professor Otte.